Hello fantastic people, I hope you are doing great. In this tutorial we'll create a very versatile health script. One for your character, all of the enemies and all of the destroyable items in the scene. Because it will utilize unit events, it will be very easy to integrate it with any existing systems that you may have. Within the next few tutorials we'll extend it by creating health bar, the damage indicators and life system. Let's start by creating new script and call it health. Then inside of it let's create a private serialized variable for the maximum HP. Then another private one for the current HP. To make sure that the character starts with full HP, let's set it to maximum in the awake method. Now in order to make sure that our HP has always the correct value, let's create property on top of it. In the getter we simply return the underscore HP. Leaving it public will allow other scripts to read the value. Then let's add private setter, and in its first line let's create a variable called isDamage. Whenever the new value is smaller than the current HP, that means the character got damaged. We'll use that information for something very interesting in the moment. Now before we assign the new value to our current HP, let's clamp it between 0 and maximum HP. Now I will create several methods that will allow other scripts to interact with our health system. What's important, inside of those scripts I will set the HP property, not the underlying field. This will make sure that the value is always clamped correctly. So I created public damage method which accepts amount and decreases the HP by that value. Then heal method which increases the HP by the given amount. Then heal full method which sets the HP value to maximum and kill method which sets the HP to 0. Then adjust method which allows to set the HP to a certain value. Now I'm scrolling to the top and exposing the max HP field. I am sure there are scripts which would be interested in reading this value, for example health bar. All of the methods that we created have just one line, so let's quickly change them into expression bodied methods. To do that we simply remove the brackets and add an arrow between the expression and the parameter. Beautiful. Okay, now let's implement the most interesting part. I add public unity event healed. I'm using the generic version of it in order to be able to pass the new HP value to all of the subscribers. Notice that in order to use unit events I need to add the using unityengine.event statement. I think there are two more events which would be interesting for us. Damaged and died. The basic idea behind unit events is that we will be able to use inspector in order to list all of the actions that should be happening when certain event occurs. So inside of our setter we can check if we got damaged and if so we can invoke the damaged event and pass to it the new HP value. If we were not damaged, the HP did not change or we were healed. So let's invoke then the healed event. And after that let's check if our HP is equal or smaller than 0, and if so, let's invoke the died event. Our script is ready, so let me show you how to use it in your game. Here I have simple vase sprite. I'm adding to it box collider 2D and our health script. Now I'm changing the maximum HP of the vase to 5. And under the died method, I create a new action by pressing the small plus icon, drag and drop the vase object over there, and as the action I select deactivating the object. Of course in your case it could be something more elaborate like spawning loot, generating particles, and maybe playing animation. Now, whenever relevant, I need to invoke the damage method on that script. It could be colliding with a bullet, weapon hit, or in case of character, stepping on a trap. So in my case I simply iterate through all of the objects in weapon range, of course only those that have our health script, and invoke on them the damage method. Now because I'm in the debug mode I can also monitor the private field. I see the HP decreased after hit as expected. I hit the vase second time and it got deactivated. Awesome. I add the health script to my enemy. When the character is damaged, I set the trigger on the animator. You see, that's the power of unit events. I don't have to write for that even one line of code. When the character dies, the same as for the vase, I simply deactivate the object. I need to add the collider 2D and everything is ready. Finally, Fantastic! And the first example will be this simple trap. On the object I have a collider 2D which is marked as a trigger. I add to it a simple script called trap. I create a field for the animator and grab it inside the awake method. Then I implement onTriggerEnter2D. In its first line, I check if the object that collided with the trap has the health script. If so, I activate the trap by setting the trigger activate on the animator. Then using our health script, I deal some damage. And then on the object that got hit, I play the damaged animation. And that's all for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, have a fantastic day, love you and bye bye!